The House Judiciary Committee has approved a bill to federally legalize marijuana, paving the way for a historic vote on the House floor.
This will remove a stain on people's records, but really a stain on the United States of America.
It's called the MORE Act, and it's being lauded by marijuana advocates and civil rights groups who say it goes further than any other proposal to legalize cannabis.
The bill would legalize cannabis at the federal level, expunge prior criminal records, and require states to resentence prisoners who are currently serving time for marijuana-related offenses. It would also establish programs to reinvest in communities that have been negatively impacted by prohibition, and that would be paid for by a 5% federal tax on legal marijuana sales.
The measure passed in the committee 24-10, with two Republicans voting yes. California Congresswoman Barbara Lee, one of the bill's co-sponsors, says this is one of the most comprehensive marijuana reform measures Congress has ever proposed.
This is what the people want, and it has nothing to do whether you smoke or not, or use cannabis or not. This is an issue of justice and fairness, and it's an issue that is a pathway to addressing the unfair mass incarceration of black and brown young people.
Several GOP members of the committee opposing the bill said they hadn't had enough time to learn about the public health impacts of legalizing marijuana.
Why haven't we had time to do what we're really supposed to do and actually go into these things in depth, bring experts in here and tell us whether this is the right thing to do or not, or at least advise us on that?
And it's not just Republicans. Some moderate Democrats, even some in House leadership, have expressed skepticism about fully legalizing marijuana. Lee says she's confident more of her colleagues will come on board when they learn about the legislation.
Well, there's not unity yet, but hopefully once it's out of committee, we'll be able to do more briefings. The organizations will meet with the members who are still on the fence. And in fact, this is about the power of the people. It's about a people's agenda that leads to some fairness and some justice.
But even if the bill does pass in the House, its prospects in the Senate aren't great. Senator Kamala Harris, a 2020 Democratic candidate, is sponsoring the Senate version of the MORE Act. In a statement to Newsy, Harris said, "Millions of Americans with marijuana-related convictions continue to face overwhelming barriers to jobs, education, and housing. That is why we must act to remove the burden of marijuana convictions and make sure these individuals have the support needed to move forward." If the MORE Act does become law, states could still choose to prohibit marijuana.